Woo! Oh, God, we love you. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we don't want to be distracted.
Hallelujah.
We don't want to be so grown, Lord God. So serious, Lord. God, we need you. We cry hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, these are your apple carts. Just turn them over. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. There are some folks at home, you need to just begin to say hallelujah. You may be listening even in the car. You need to just begin to open your mouth and speak hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. 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 Let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. You know what that is? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go with me to Acts chapter 2 if you would. Say hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. We were up the mountain, prayer mountain, and we had a wonderful time at night in the Lord in a worship service. Hallelujah. My dad came to me after and he said, "What have you been drinking?" Hallelujah. I've had a big old glass of hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll take some hallelujah, please. Thank you,
Lord.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. Hallelujah. Let those that long for joy shout for it. Hallelujah. 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 There is a river, hallelujah, that makes glad the people of God. Hallelujah. Ask that you might receive, that your joy may be full. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. Romans, skip Acts. For now. I want to think we're going to go to Romans, I want to say 11. Verse 17. Hallelujah. Whew. Hallelujah. But if some of the branches were broken off, and you, although a wild olive shoot, were grafted in among the others, and now share in the nourishing root of the olive tree, do not be arrogant toward the branches. If you are, remember, it is not you who support the root, but the root that supports you. Then you will say, branches are broken off so that I might be grafted in. That is true. They were broken off because of their unbelief, but you stand fast through faith. You are engrafted to the olive tree by faith. There were branches broken off. That's a word of caution. Because of unbelief. Hallelujah. Whew. Thank you, Jesus. Father, Lord, I can't make you do it, but I'm asking you for what is here to be there in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for it. But you are engrafted, though you were a wild tree, you are grafted to the olive tree by faith. Somebody say, by faith.
By faith.
Hallelujah. Now go with me to John chapter 15. We're not going to be real long today, but the Lord said to do this first instead of do this last. So we're going to do it like this, and I pray, hallelujah. Chapter 15 of the book of John says, I am the true vine. My Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes it, that it may bear more fruit. Already you are clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. Verse 4. Abide in me. Remain in me. Stay attached to me. Live with and in me. The word abide means to remain in me. Remain in me, and now look at this one, and I in you. Remain in me by faith, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself. Let me give you a better word than fruit. Manifestation. As you will not have a manifestation of God by yourself. Come on. Neither can you. Hallelujah. Unless it abides in the vine. Abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine. It's what you do consistently that brings power. It is not what you do momentarily or seldomly. It is a consistent abiding in Christ that brings forth manifestation of Christ in your life. And these are the fruit of the Spirit, the manifestation of the Spirit. Joy, peace, love, come on, gentleness, meekness, kindness. Oh, we love the faith word because it's a fruit of the Spirit. And with faith, you can believe. But what about gentleness? What about kindness? Everybody, you know, the disciples, they said, Lord, give us more faith. But not many people go around saying, God, give me more gentleness, more kindness. But I want to tell you something. The thing that's lacking, the thing that the church needs more than anything, are the fruit of the Spirit that the world is hungry for today. We need to manifest God in ways that the world is not. Does that make sense? If the fruit of the Spirit is love, that means there's no love in the world. People are hungry for that fruit. They want to reach to the vine, take off a piece, and eat it because they have no love in their lives. And when you come with love, real, unconditional love, sacrificial love, love that says, you slap me, I'll turn my cheek, you take my coat, I'll give you my cloak. You ask for a mile, here's two. Come on. And they taste and see that the Lord is good. Gentleness, meekness. Well, bless God, ain't nobody going to get over on me. Kindness. Wow. It is the manifestation of the Spirit of Jesus. And we don't manifest it because we momentarily, hallelujah, or read a devotional in the morning that's one scripture long and we post it to Facebook. Nothing wrong with that.
But there is a word that is the key to power. Are you ready for that word? How many of you want to know the word?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah gets you out of a jam. But the word abide will keep you from even getting in the jam. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, Jesus said. He said that there are branches that were broken off because of unbelief, but by faith you are now attached. Even though you were wild, you're attached to the vine. He said, I am the vine, you are the branches. And look what he says. Let's go back to 15. Verse 5. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much manifestation. You want to manifest the things of God? You want to see people saved? You want to see people delivered and healed and set free? You want peace in your home? You want blessing, prosperity to begin to overtake the troubles and the scratching and clawing of the fleshly way of doing things? If you want that to happen, it's going to take one thing, abide. It is a consistent abiding in Christ and allowing Him to abide in you. Verse 6. Well, let me go to continue 5. He bears much fruit, for apart from me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers. And branches are gathered and thrown into the fire and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified. Oh God, I want to bring glory to your name. How do you bring glory to the name of our Father? Abide. You abide. That you bear much fruit and so prove to be my disciples. Disciples manifest their master. Let me say that again. Come on, somebody should be Facebooking this one. Disciples manifest their master. If you want to be a disciple of Christ, you must abide. If my words abide in you and you abide in me, you will ask what you will and it will be glory to my Father to do it. And he goes on to say, as my Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Equal to the love of the Father in my life, I love you. Did we not just spend all that time up here worshiping him? Claiming, believing, receiving his love? Come on. As my Father has loved me, this is written in red in your Bible, folks, so have I loved you. Abide, remain consistent in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you. I've said this before, and I'm going to say it again this morning. The church is so sad because there's no manifestation of their Father in her. We are not representing the God whom we talk about. Because we know about Him, but we are not discipled from Him. But God is looking for a manifestation of Himself in His children. The whole earth is groaning, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. I want you to think of it this way. The earth itself is waiting for more Jesus. The people of this earth are waiting for more Jesus. How do we get more Jesus? We have to spend time with the Master. If you spend time with the Master, you abide with Him. You remain connected to Him. Come on, I'm tearing myself up here. You could see this sword cutting me left and right. You'd see I'm bleeding pools. You remain in Him, and His words remain in you. You will manifest like a fruit tree. I don't ever, ever see a branch on a tree go, come on, apple. Doesn't work that way. That tree's not constipated. Apple, there it is. I didn't do it. Who did it? The root did it. Come on. And what does the root come from? The seed. And who is the seed? Jesus. All I need to do is abide in Him, and the strength to overcome my obstacle will be there. All I need to do is abide in Him, and healing will begin to manifest itself. All I need to do is abide in Him, and prosperity will begin to turn back my way. Come on. That's the problem with the church in America. We don't want abide. We want microwave. I want a little dab of do-ya. Come on. Dippity-doo. Anybody remember dippity-doo? I just want, if I can get a moment, if I can just get a fix, I need a hit of Jesus. Just need my fix. But He said, you must abide in Me. And the reason why when we go to all these countries, well, there's a TV there. When we go to all these countries and we think, God, why do you manifest so strong here? And it's like pulling teeth here at home. Is because in many of these countries, just to survive day to day, they must abide with Him. But we have been so blessed, come on, that we fit God into our schedule. And there are some that are supposed to be here this morning, but because it was inconvenient to their sleep, come on. And it's not just about church. Do you abide with Him? I abide more with my wife than I do with my God. That ought not be so. Jesus wants to share me with my wife, but He doesn't want to lose me to anything. Amen. Do you get that? I'm not saying don't have a strong marriage. Have a strong marriage. But remember, a strong marriage isn't between two people, it's between three. Because to put up with me takes Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say abide.
Abide.
I want you to think about the areas of your life where God has called you to abide with Him, and you said, I'm going to do this instead. That's what we're going to get rid of. Everything that needs to be pruned, that's where I'm at. The church will make up rules and say, well, you know, to be pruned, you're going to have to put a scarf over your head. Or to be pruned, you're going to have to take that makeup off. Or to be pruned, you know, you're going to have to grow that beard. But a funny one with no mustache. Right? The church thinks that abiding is an outward thing. You don't understand. I can abide with God in places that nobody else wants to be. Come on. In the shower, in the bathroom, I can abide with God. I have no problems at all knowing that, hey, naked I came into this world and naked I shall return. I ain't hiding nothing from God. You can be doing dishes and praying in the Holy Ghost. Are you with me? And it isn't about all the Christian things. Well, I got to have Christian this and Christian this, and then pretty soon you got every bumper sticker, you got every book, you got everything that you could possibly, you got all the paraphernalia, 6 crosses, you're good to go. Hallelujah, anointed yourself 4 times. You look like a greasy Mr. T walking out of your house. Some of you are too young to even know that. It's a heart thing. I abide with Him in me. And therefore, I can pray continually without ceasing. Are you with me? No matter what, I look for Him and His consent. I have to confess something to you. We were doing inventory this week. Hallelujah. That's a sacrifice of praise. And we had a bunch of bags of salt for the road. Now, we don't sell that in 91 degree weather. And so it was on a pallet up in the steel, waiting for the seasons to turn again. But it has to be counted in the books, right? Because it's something that's in the building. And I noticed that there are some bags that were a different price. And we were counting it and we were listing all the prices so that we'd get an accurate count. And the Lord began to convict me. He said, "You're counting these at the wrong price." I said, "Well, these are the higher price. There's only a few bags of that. And we don't even sell." Abide. Come on. He is the Holy Spirit. He is the Spirit of truth. Come on. And I thought, oh God. And you know, that thing gave me fits all the rest of the night. And I was so grateful for conviction. Because I know what it is to go long periods of your life where you've turned the conviction off. To the point where you beg Him to convict you again. A calloused heart is the most dangerous thing a Christian can have, next to blessing. With blessing, we can forget God and still think we're blessed. Welcome to America. The second thing is a calloused heart, where we no longer even want to hear what God has to say. God is looking for a people that will abide in Him, that will remain connected to Him. What does all this have to do with communion? Let's go now to 1 Corinthians. Hallelujah. Come on, is there a hallelujah in the house?
Hallelujah.
He is still in the midst of us. 1 Corinthians, and we're going to go to chapter 11. But I want to share something that Jesus shared with me this week. When I say that, it's not because I've had this great week of abiding, because I haven't. You want to know what happened? I let Him count it at the wrong price. And I'm confessing it to you this morning. I had other things to do. The time had missed. Have you ever missed your time of conviction? Listen to me, America. Don't miss your time of conviction. It may be the last call to repentance you get. There will be a day, remember, that the ark will be shut. When the trumpet sounds, it is not just jubilee for those that remain. It is judgment to those that refuse. It's going to be the most triumphant and the most horrible thing God has to do. 1 Corinthians 11. Verse 23. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you. Boy, that's the Christian life right there. I'm sorry. I have to stop with that for just a moment. The Christian life is to receive from the Lord and to give to others. Peter and John said, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk." a manifestation of their master. Hallelujah. I don't want butts in seats. I want disciples in streets. Hallelujah. Write her down. Hallelujah. God is looking for a manifestation of His sons. Come on. Just like His Son. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you. Hallelujah. That the Lord Jesus, on the night that He was betrayed, He took bread, and when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And the Lord began to minister to me, and He said, "Son, my body is the vine, and I broke it so that you could be joined to it." God help us. My body is the vine, and branches were torn away. Come on. My body is the vine. This is my body, which is broken for you. We are engrafted to that body which was broken. But if the body wasn't broken, you and I, who were of a wild olive tree, never could have been engrafted to it. It had to have its branches taken out so that those that would come by faith could be brought in. How could Paul say that I would that I went to hell so that Israel would be saved? Except he knew that it was through Israel's denial of their Messiah that the world could receive him. God have mercy. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. For we are abiding in something that they were born to abide in. Hallelujah. While your ancestors were raping and pillaging, their ancestors were wandering through the desert. We don't deserve it. We didn't earn it. It is by grace through faith that we are saved. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night that He was betrayed, took bread, and when He had given thanks, He broke Himself. And He said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, He took the cup after supper, and He said, "This cup is the new covenant, the new agreement, the new testament in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." My blood is the new agreement between mankind and God. It is every promise being yes and amen because of my blood. Your prayers are not answered because of your stars on a chart or you showed up to a prayer meeting. Your prayers are answered because of the blood of the body of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The body was broken so I could be engrafted in and abide in Him. And what is in the body? What is the life of the body? The blood. And the blood now of Christ can flow into my life and bear fruit through me. Say, I have the blood of Christ. Wow. Come on, somebody. This cup is the new covenant in my blood. I sign it with blood. My healing in blood. My presence in blood. My protection in blood. My provision in blood. You need a pillar of fire by night and a cloud by day. It's in my blood. You need the wheels of your enemy to come off. It's in my blood. You need the mind of Christ. It's in my blood. You need peace which passes understanding. My peace which I leave with you. My blood. I pay for it in my blood. The transaction is blood. Hallelujah. Can we bring the elements into the room? Can I get my kids to help there? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow. That makes me white as snow. The exchange rate of heaven is the blood. Whatever you bring and you set up on the counter in heaven and they exchange with the answered prayer, it's the blood that pays for it. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will bear fruit and manifest my God in your life. Hallelujah. Boy, he wants one of them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pull mine. Paul understood something because he received it from Jesus. There was another man named Peter. And Peter made a statement that only God the Father could have revealed to him. And that was, you are the Christ. You are the anointed one and his anointing. You are the Messiah. You are the Son of Man, the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. You are Emmanuel, God with us. And Jesus said to Peter, he said, Peter, man did not teach you this thing, but it was revealed to you by God the Father. Now some of you have been trying to teach and share the love and the mercy and the grace of God with others in your life, but you have not seen those people receive the same revelation. You have friends and family, co-workers that need to get saved, that need Jesus. Many of them confess Jesus, but there is no manifestation because there's no abiding in their life at all. Come on. I've got it. But it is not the words of your understanding that will bring them to Christ. It is words of revelation that will bring men and women to Christ. It is manifestations of God that will reveal to them who He is. When a man is able for himself to taste the fruit of God that hangs from the vines of the branch of the root of, then he will know for himself, I heard you tell me about this God. But when I tasted and I saw for myself, my eyes were open and I saw that I was naked and I received Him as my robes of righteousness. Only God can open the eyes of a sinner. And He does it through the fruit of the Spirit, manifest through the sons and daughters of God, the disciples of the King. It is going to be through your kindness that they come. Through your gentleness, your meekness, your faith. It takes faith to say, let me pray for you in the middle of the mall. It takes faith to step up and say, you know what, you're going into surgery, I'd like to pray with you. It takes faith when somebody says, that word that they so flippantly think is a swear word, but to you, He's the King of the universe. And instead you say, well, hallelujah. When they say Jesus Christ, you go, hallelujah, is He here? God corrected me again this week. Boy, it's been a fun week. I know. Hallelujah. He's talking in tongues already. Amen. Hallelujah. That's some prophecy going on right there. He's prophesying a hamburger and a hot dog. I want you to know, when the disciples said, Lord, do you want us to call down fire on them? Jesus' response wasn't calm down, boys. He actually said, you don't know what spirit you are of. The Son of Man came not to judge the world, to condemn it, but to save it. There is a day of judgment, and it is so near at hand. But until then, we are still about our Father's business, begging, allowing all that would come, even if it costs us our life, to eat of the fruit of the Garden of Eden that grows from us on the tree of life. Hallelujah. Jesus is the tree of life. And you have been engrafted by faith to the tree of life. It's not a Bible story. It's not a felt tree on a Sunday school board somewhere. It is a man named Jesus. And you are the branches. And you are invited to be a disciple that abides. Paul said this. He said, I received from the Lord what I also delivered unto you. And this morning, all I can say as we close is what I've received from the Lord, I've delivered to you. That on the night that He was betrayed, you know, we could be mad at Adam, but I've done the same. We could be upset and be glad that our name isn't Judas. But how many times have you kissed the Lord and betrayed Him? But God is merciful. And I want to encourage every man, woman, and child that is hearing me this morning that this is not just a juice and a wafer. This is a statement of faith, an act of contact, saying that this is His body. He is the tree that had branches removed that I might be attached to Him. And this morning the Bible says, Paul said in the same way, verse 26, for as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes. You proclaim His death. Yeah. If part of it didn't die, you could have never been engrafted. Whoever therefore eats the bread and drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty concerning the body and the blood of the Lord. What is that manner? If you do not consider His body and His blood. We use this time often to repent of our sins, and that's the right thing to do. But it's not just to repent, it's to receive. Because repentance means nothing. You can beg and beg and beg and beg in sorrow for forgiveness, but it's only when you believe you've received forgiveness. Do you have it? Come on, some of you need to be set free from shame and guilt and your past. some familiar spirits been popping their heads up, and you should have popped their heads off. I believe God loves me because this is His body, which was broken. Whew. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, Mamba Yesu. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That was for me. The wheels are in reverse. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus lifted up the bread and He gave thanks. If you're in this place and you have not been abiding in Christ, He wants to engraft you to Himself again. He wants to strengthen that bond. He wants to tie Himself to you. He wants to be one with you. It's as simple as saying, Lord, I repent of anything that's not you, and I ask you to forgive me. Jesus took His body and He lifted it up and He broke it. And He said, this is my body, the tree of life, which is broken that you might be engrafted into it. If you abide in me and my life abides in you. Hallelujah. This is your invitation. Eat it all. In the same manner, He lifted up the cup. He didn't lift it up between Him and the men. He lifted it up between Him and the Father, and He gave thanks. And He said, Father, I signed the covenant in my blood, that anything they ask in my name, you will do it for them. And He said, take and drink all of it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say it with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to say this as we finish. As soon as they did this, they sang a hymn, and then Jesus went out and proved it. The very next phase of His ministry was to prove it. Hallelujah. 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 Father, as we take this time of fellowship with one another, we fellowship first with You, that we might have something that we would receive of You to give to others. Help us to bear fruit and to remain in You, Lord. Help us to hear and obey the conviction of the Holy Spirit. Help us to walk in Your joy and fulfill the discipleship of Christ. In Jesus' name. Somebody say it again with me. Hallelujah. God bless you. I appreciate it today. Had a good time in praise. Now I'm going to have a good time at the grill.